Earlier in this course, we learned what core data is and is not. In this lesson, we zoom in on the building blocks of the core data framework. As I mentioned earlier, it is key that you understand how the various classes that make core data tick play together. The star players of the core data framework are the managed object model, the managed object context, and the persistent store coordinator. This diagram shows how these classes relate to one another. We will use this diagram as a guideline during this lesson. The managed object model is an instance of the NS managed object model class. A typical core data application has one instance of the NS managed object model class, but it is possible to have multiple. The managed object model instance represents the data model of the core data application. This diagram shows that the managed object model is connected to the data model. The data model is represented by a file in the application bundle. It contains the data schema of the application. This is something we revisit later in this course when we start working with core data. The data model is represented by a file in the application bundle that contains the data schema of the application. The data schema is nothing more than a collection of entities. An entity can have attributes and relationships, which make up the data model of the application. We explore the data model in more detail later. For now, remember that the managed object model is an instance of the NS managed object model class, and it represents the data model of the core data application. A managed object context is represented by an instance of the NS managed object context class. A core data application has one or more managed object contexts. Each managed object context manages a collection of model objects, instances of the NS managed object class. The managed object context receives the model objects through a persistent store coordinator, as you can see in this diagram. A managed object context keeps a reference to the persistent store coordinator of the application. The managed object context is the object you interact with most. It creates, reads, updates, and deletes model objects. From a developer's perspective, the NS managed object context class is the workhorse of the core data framework. The persistent store coordinator is represented by an instance of the NS persistent store coordinator class, and it plays a key role in every core data application. While it is possible to have multiple persistent store coordinators, most applications have only one. Very, very rarely is there a need to have multiple persistent store coordinators in one application. The persistent store coordinator keeps a reference to the managed object model, and every parent managed object context keeps a reference to the persistent store coordinator. But wait, what is a parent managed object context? Later in the series, we take a closer look at parent and child managed object context. Don't worry about this for now. This diagram tells us that the persistent store coordinator is connected to one or more persistent stores. What is a persistent store? Remember that core data manages an object graph. The framework is only useful if the persistent store coordinator is connected to one or more persistent stores. Out of the box, core data supports three persistent store types: a SQLite database, a binary store, and an in-memory store. Each persistent store type has its pros and cons. Most applications use a SQLite database as their persistent store. As we saw earlier in this course, SQLite is lightweight and very fast. It is great for mobile applications and desktop applications. Now that we know what the core data stack consists of, it is time to explore how it operates in an application. The heart of a core data application is the persistent store coordinator. The persistent store coordinator is instantiated first when the core data stack is created. But to create the persistent store coordinator, we need a managed object model. Why is that? The persistent store coordinator needs to know what the data schema of the application looks like. After setting up the persistent store coordinator and the managed object model, the workhorse of the core data stack is initialized: the managed object context. Remember that a managed object context keeps a reference to the persistent store coordinator. With the core data stack set up, the application is ready to use core data to interact with the application's persistent store. In most cases, your application interacts with the persistent store coordinator through the manage object context. You will rarely, if ever, directly interact with the persistent store coordinator or the manage object model. As I mentioned earlier, the NSManageObjectContext class is the class you interact with most frequently. The ManageObjectContext is used to create, read, update, and delete records. When the changes made in the ManageObjectContext are saved, the ManageObjectContext pushes them to the persistent store coordinator, which sends the changes to the corresponding persistent store. If your application has multiple persistent stores, the persistent store coordinator figures out which persistent store needs to store the changes of the manage object context. Now that you know what core data is and how the core data stack is set up, it is time to write some code. In the next lessons, we create a core data stack and we explore the classes we discussed in this lesson.